This is the Amy Dymbosky Show on the Talk of the Valley, KVNT, 1020 AM and 92.5 FM, and live online at 1020kvnt.com. From 4 p.m. to 6 p.m. Monday through Friday, join Amy Dymbosky to talk about what matters to Alaskans. The phone lines are open at 357-5868, 357-5868. Good afternoon, Alaska. Here's Amy Dymbosky.
Welcome back to the Amy Dymbosky Show here on KVNT. If you'd like to call in, be part of the show, the number is 357-5868. We're on the phone with Greg Jones. He's called in to say hi. Are you still there, Greg?
I'm still here.
Great, great. Hey, Greg, you know, last time you called in, I appreciate you calling in. This is probably the third time we've spoken, and I appreciate your willingness to engage. But the last time you called in, I had not read the op-ed that you wrote in the ADN, and I want to ask you about that because, frankly, I think we're past the patty cakes now, and I think I want a direct answer from you. Why are you going around telling people I called you a terrorist?
The article doesn't say that, does it?
No, it doesn't, but you said I'm spreading hate against you, and I'm certainly not. So why are you lying? Why are you saying that?
Well, I never said what you're saying. I mean, what's happening is things have been misconstrued. Okay, and I never said that. Never.
Okay. No. Let me sell this. Let me read you your own words, right here. It says, Amy Dymbosky, Anchorage Municipal Assembly member, suggested that I, Gregory Jones, could be involved with a terrorist organization. Now, Greg, on this show, you did say you were a member of Muslims of America, formerly Jamaat al-Fukra. You said you grew up in it. Both your uncles were in it. Your dad was in it. It was just something you grew up in. So, again, right there, your first statement. I didn't say that. I asked you if it was true, and you said yes. So then, let me go on to the next statement. Dymbosky has attributed baseless, fake, false news claims to me solely due to my faith as a Muslim. No, it's not. I actually never talked about your faith. I talked about an affiliation with a group that the FBI has deemed an international terrorist organization. So again, now you're taking this as a political crusade to say something that I did not say. I specifically asked you if you were a member of the group, but you said, yeah, we moved on. It was no big deal. But now you're saying I'm spreading Islamophobia. It's not true. I haven't talked about Islam. I've talked about a group. So
I would love to.
So I'm going to set this up for you. I want to know why it is when I gave you a fair question as a candidate about a group and you affirmed that you were a member of the group, we moved on, I learned more about it, I shared an article about the group, yes, I talked about the FBI documents about the group, and you run to get your 5 minutes of fame and start telling people that somehow I'm accusing you of being a terrorist or I'm accusing you of being associated with terrorists. I'm not accusing you of anything, my friend. So I want to know why you're
to me. Okay,
go for it. Go for it.
Allow me to ask the question. So what? My understanding was that there was a Fox News report which said that there was a compound in Alaska stockpiling weapons and that I might be associated with it. And so I think that has been totally unsubstantiated first of all, I'm not stockpiling any weapons.
I never said you were. Let's go back to the focus. Let me ask you this, Greg. Are you a member of Muslims of America? Why are you a member of a group formerly known as Jamaat al-Fukra? Sheikh Jilani is the head of that group. Why are you associated with that group? And instead of answering that question, you're trying to say that I'm calling you a terrorist or saying you're stockpiling weapons. Didn't happen. The question about it is, why are you a member of that group?
I'm gonna answer your question. If you let me talk, then I can answer the question. Okay, but the group Muslim of America is, let me first off say it is working with local authorities. It is working with various churches. It is working with Jewish organizations to spread peace.
Greg, that's not true. That is so not true. Right here. Let me tell you what the FBI says about this group. It says MOA is a North American international radical fundamentalist group. And then it starts to talk about it, and it says right here, the leadership of MOA extols membership to pursue a policy of jihad or holy war against individuals or groups. Stop trying to convince us this is not a radical group. Why are you associated with this group?
So I'm working with the FBI. They're working with the FBI. And if you talk to the authorities, you'll see that report that you are reading is not up to date. That's the truth.
Well, I know what the truth is. Okay, let me ask you another question.
Why don't you contact the local authorities?
Well, you don't know who I've contacted, actually.
I'm working with the Anchorage Police Department. I'm working with the mayor and other people, you know, in peaceful programs right here. I'm calling you today to spread peace.
Well, I hope so, but my thing is, let me ask you a question. And I appreciate your message and your well wishes, and I wish you the very same. But when you call into my show, we need to start with you can't call in and play nice and then write in the paper that I'm spreading all these lies that I didn't do, Greg. You have to be responsible. You can't say what you're saying because it's simply not true. So I want to know why you're going around telling people that I'm saying you lived on a compound or I'm spreading this. I mean, the fact of the matter is you've never answered the question why you belong to this group that the FBI themselves has deemed as an international risk.
That's not true. Let me say something. Your report that there is a compound in Alaska stockpile.
It's not my report. It is not my report. It's not my report.
You're spreading that news. It's not true.
Okay, Greg, let me go at a different way. You're not listening.
It's not true.
We're not communicating well. We're not communicating well because I never spread the rumor that there's a compound in Alaska. I asked the question. Okay. Let me ask you one more question. Okay. Let me ask you one more question. Have you ever been to Pakistan?
I've been several places. Why are you asking that?
Yes or no. Just yes or no, Greg. Have you been to Pakistan since 9/11? Have you ever met Sheikh Jalali? Yes or no, please. Right here, live radio. Clear the air.
I have met him.
And is he still the leader of Muslims of America?
Yes, he is. And he's working with the authorities.
Yeah. Greg, I've got a little bone to pick. You called in and said we worship the same Jesus. You know what? The Jesus I worship, the real Jesus, was born of a virgin. He died on a cross, and he was resurrected for my sin. The Isa in the Quran didn't do any of those three things. You're talking about another Jesus. You still there?
It's the son of Jesus, son of Mary. That's who the Holy Quran talks about.
Yes, I'd love to talk to you more about this. I've read the Quran and studied it. I would love
Jesus, son of Virgin Mary. That's who the Holy Quran.
Amen. Well, Greg, we really appreciate you calling in. If you'd ever love to come in and talk about this, I think you and I need a little bit of clear in the air because I think the rhetoric you've been spreading has been hateful. It's absolutely been false, but I appreciate you calling in to wish us a happy holiday season, and I wish you the very best. Merry Christmas.
God bless Jesus, and praise the Lord.
Amen to that. Amen. You're listening to the Amy Dabosky Show here on KVNT. We'll be right back. Welcome back to the Amy Dabosky Show here on KVNT. If you'd like to call in, be part of the show. The number is 357-5868. Justin, so much for my lighthearted Christmas show. Here's the thing. You know what? I feel like I haven't been treating Greg the same way I would be treating every other politician. Jeff Landfield calls in and he says something stupid. I challenge him. I have given Greg a pass after pass after pass. After the last time he called in, I hadn't read his op-ed. And then I go to the ADN and I read his op-ed, which was full of misdirection, it was completely deceitful. Let's just be honest. I'm going to read you right now part of that op-ed. Right here, what it says is, his title is Dombrowski Should Apologize or Step Down. Every American is afforded the right of freedom of speech, but character assassinations and slander are outside the spirit of America and maybe against the law. On December 3rd, through her Facebook page and radio show, Amy Dombrowski, Anchorage Municipal Assembly member, suggested that I, Gregory Yvonne Shabab Jones, could be involved with a terrorist organization. I didn't claim it. I didn't assert it. You said it, you dumbass. Domboski has attributed baseless fake Fox News claim to me solely due to my faith. No, it has nothing to do with your faith, my friend. It has everything to do with the organization. This is no different than the Schaefer Cox group up in Fairbanks or the Westboro Baptist Church or some other group. The KKK, if it was any group, that's what I was talking about. And I think that's why we're having this disconnect. Because I'm talking about the group, and he immediately is screaming, Islamophobia. You know what? If you're going to have a real debate with me, if you're going to have a real conversation, come to me with facts. Because crying and whining, you know, isn't going to do it. My listeners are much smarter than that. It is time that you man up and act like one. If you're going to call me a name, or if you're going to say I'm being racist or Islamophobic or whatever, you better bring the damn facts. Because, my friend, you don't have them.
Yeah,
it never happened. Never happened. So let me go on to his, this is his op-ed. It continues to say, Domboski has attributed a baseless fake Fox News claims to me solely due to my faith as a Muslim. No, I didn't. It has everything to do with the fact you told me you were a member of this group. You said it. I didn't say it. You said it. This self-serving promotion of Islamophobia is par for the course as the Islamophobes she sourced, such as Pamela Geller, Ryan Morrow, and his organization, the Clarion Project, have built lucrative careers on hate and fear-mongering. Okay, let's talk about what we built that report on. I'm going to read this to you. I've read it to you multiple times. I actually have it still in my hand. This is an FBI report. This FBI report was declassified in 2007, all right? And this is what it says about Muslims of America, the group that Greg Jones has multiple times now admitted he is a member of. Let me just get to it. Here it is, directly from the FBI. I will read it word for word. By way of background, the Muslims of America, MOA, a.k.a. FUCRA, the MOA is a North American International Radical Fundamentalist group. It emerged in 1982 as a splinter group of Dar-ul-Islam, which previously espoused calls for young men to join Afghan guerrillas in their fight against the Soviet Union. The MOA is now an autonomous organization which possesses an infrastructure capable of planning and mounting terrorist campaigns overseas and within the U.S. Houston knows, based upon information uncovered by Albany Division, in their investigation, MOA members have participated in 10 murders, one disappearance, three firebombings, and one attempted firebombing, and two explosive bombings with one attempted bombing. The documented propensity for violence by this organization supports the belief the leadership of MOA extols membership to pursue a policy of jihad or holy war against individuals or groups it considers enemies of Islam, which includes the U.S. government. Members of the MOA are encouraged to travel to Pakistan to receive religious and military/terrorist training from Sheikh Jalani. Okay, let me ask you one more question. Have you ever been to Pakistan?
I've been several places. Why are you asking that?
Yes or no. Just yes or no, Greg. Have you been to Pakistan since 9/11? Have you ever met Sheikh Jalani? Yes or no, please. Right here, live radio. Clear the air.
I've met him. I have met him.
And is he still the leader of Muslims of America?
Yes, he is. And he's working with the authorities.